Okay, you're doing great. You've really learned a lot of powerful mathematics in the last 20 minutes. So, let's think how we're going to use this. It doesn't seem to make sense to keep calculating the sine of 37 degrees every single time we encounter a triangle with a 37 degree angle. This number is never changing. The sine will always be 3 over 5. So what they did in Eratosthenes' day was calculate large tables of trigonometric ratios. They would find the sine, cosine, and tangent of a variety of angles and save it away for future reference. Here's an example table of trigonometric ratios. In the columns, we have sine, cosine, and tangent, and we have these values computed for, well, just a few degrees here, 40, 41, 42 degrees. In a better table, we'd have a larger range of angles and higher resolution, so we'd have 40.1 degrees, 40.2 degrees, and so on. But this will work for now. What this table allows us to do is something really amazing. So let's say we have a triangle, and it's a right triangle with an angle here of 42 degrees, and let's say we know this length. It's 1,000 meters. How can I find this length? This is something we haven't done yet. What I can do is say, I know that the ratio of this side to this side is totally independent of how long these sides actually are. In fact, this side being adjacent to 42 degrees and this side being hypotenuse, looks like we're going to want to use a cosine, which compares adjacent to hypotenuse. In fact, what I can say is that the cosine of 42 degrees, which I can look up in my table, it's 0.743, must be equal to the adjacent side, I'll call that x for now, over the hypotenuse. And the hypotenuse has a length of 1,000 meters. This is a huge, huge tool to have, because now all we have to do is multiply by 1,000 to solve for x, and we find that x is equal to 743 meters. Now I'm going to give you a shot. Let's call this unknown length y. Can you go through a similar set of steps, maybe you won't be using cosine this time, to figure out how long is this side y?